Hello there guys, welcome to Savotta Russia, welcome back to the channel. So today we're in the forest. It's been a while since I made a video in the forest. I mean, when I go to the forest, I like to make videos where I show you guys something, not just walking around. Anyway, sometimes I do that as well, right? But yeah, today we're heading up to the campsite that which Mr. Savotta Russia visited, because I had some projects and stuff up there. I actually plan to go for a double or triple overnight or something like that, but at the moment I simply don't have the time for it, and yeah, weather is not really playing well. It's raining a little bit today. It's not too bad, but it's not that I'm afraid of rain, right? But when I go out to make a video for you guys, it's better we don't have too much rain, because it's not good to make videos in the rain actually. The forest is still relatively wet. Rubber boots, yeah, that's nothing new. I wear rubber boots a lot. If you should be in doubt what I mean about the forest is still a little bit wet, then that's what I mean. It's of course not like this everywhere, but it's wet. I'm also out with the Savotta Jääkäri medium backpack. It's the first real hike with the little backpack there. We're having relatively fresh moose tracks on the trail here. And that's one reason I have the little Makarov with me today. Because, yeah, it'll at least scare it off, I think. And that's jagger. Somebody have harvested a while ago, a few years ago. And this is gonna kill the tree anyway. But this is not gonna kill the tree whatsoever. Hello there guys! Guys, again, you made it earlier than I did. You were pretty fast guys. We definitely need to get the scythe up here and cut a little bit of vegetation. Here we have an older Siberian log fire, and here we have the shelter that I started. That is one of the things I wanted to finish up. I wanted to get up here with the mini crawler, as I said, 2-3 days. And one of the things we should finish up is the shelter here. But we're gonna have to finish it up at some point. We also have to get the bark off of this guy here and all that good stuff. But more about that later. So I just spent a few moments setting up a little bit of a shelter there, a tarp, because yeah, as I said, it is supposed to rain today. We actually are supposed to have thunder for the next 3 days or something like that. It's just a British basha. It has been with me for a long time. They are super sturdy. If you get the original ones and not the copies from a company I don't remember what's called any longer, but it ends on Tex. You Brits know what I'm talking about. These guys, they're awesome. I'm keeping part of a roll of baling wire at camp here. So that's what I used for attaching the tarp there. Normally preparing for rain is the best way to avoid it, but not right now. So it was not a bad idea to pitch this little tarp here, because it started to rain pretty well. Too well. Let's see what's gonna happen. But I think we're gonna light up the Siberian log fire anyway. It's only 3 logs, but I've often been bragging about that it's a good fire in the rain, so let's check it out. We actually have some thunder going on out there. That's awesome, because I'm on a hilltop. But I guess that's just how it is. I heard it twice now. It seems to be coming closer. So yeah, I have both a top and a poncho, an axe and a saw. You guys know that's pretty rare. I carry an axe actually, just on small trips. I'm out checking out the Savotta Jääkäri medium pack here. How it is hiking with, how much gear I can carry in it. It's not that big a pack, but I think it's like 30, 35 liters and it can be expanded at the top and so on. But you can hold a good amount of stuff in that guy and it's very comfortable. I've been riding on motorcycle with it, of course, on the hill road. Awesome pack, and there'll of course be link in the description to the pack, because many of you guys always ask what I'm using of this and that. But check the links in the description. Also, if you want to support the channel and all that good stuff, buy merchandise and whatnot. We have to make some, I already made some Siberian feather sticks, right? And the Kansball here is super awesome for that purpose. This is actually a pretty tough piece of pine. It has been drying for a long, long time. And for you guys who don't know, the advantage of these Siberian feather sticks is that they of course catch on fire pretty easy, and they get thicker and thicker, so they have actually some burn material in them, so to speak. Alright guys, rolling thunder and everything. But here we have a good pile of Siberian feather sticks. We're gonna place them out there on the Siberian log fire and see how it performs. Now it looks pretty alright, but we have thunder here and there, so yeah, let's see if I can make a video on fire in the rain. Oh, Siberian log fire in the rain anyway. We're gonna stuff it down here into the birch bark. It's most likely gonna curl up and make a mess when we light it, but that's how it is. And this Siberian log fire, I'm not completely sure when I made it, if it was during the winter or autumn of 2019. We're 2020 now, right? But it's been standing there as usual for at least half a year. I think we have a good one coming out there. Big boom. So in fear of repeating myself, and for the guys who do not know, this is a Siberian native way of making fire, with especially pine. It's the most efficient way to burn pine, and it's a very low maintenance fire. And what else is there to be said? It radiates a lot of heat this direction, of course. I have shown this countless times, but this is an awesome type of fire, and if you live in a place with conifer forest, it's definitely a fire you should know and get familiar with, because it's a lifesaver when it's cold especially, and doesn't take a lot of work. So there we have it, a reactivated Siberian log fire. The base log there is of course most likely very damp, so we need some sticks and stuff there to keep it going until it dries itself out, which can take a long, long time. But if we take a super dry, dead standing pine and cut it down in logs and so on. This is just for you who do not know this fire, right? Then the base log and the top logs will at some point burn by themselves without any additional tinder or help. Normally I use 5 or 7 top logs. So we have more rain coming in. A good amount. We have the fire going out there. I've been out collecting some materials for my cooking stand, for a new cooking stand. But let's see what's going on with this rain. Because we're not gonna do much cooking stand under the tarp here. And as I said, it's not awesome to record outside in the rain. It's not rain running on the lens and so on. Let's see how it goes. It's raining. It's raining good. It's of course not hammering down, but we're getting there. We're getting there. I'm glad I have a poncho with me and the tarp. If not, I would have been out of here already. But let's take a look at the fire out there. It's doing pretty alright. And that's not an optimal Siberian log fire. It should have at least 2 more logs. And we have a better cover. I can see it's it is dying down a little bit. Because as I said, it's not an optimal Siberian log fire. It's 3 logs. And they've been laying there for at least half a year. But it's going. I'm pretty sure if I add some more firewood, it will keep going, so I might just try that. Silky BigBoy 2000. Awesome soul. Check the links in the description. As you can see, the fire is not doing half bad. The rain is definitely picking up momentum. I think it's over soon. Well, look at that. It's been raining almost half an hour, 25 minutes or 23, 24, 26, who knows. Something like that. 13:49 and it was 13:20 or something. It's doing pretty alright, it's struggling a little bit. It's doing pretty alright. An ordinary fire would have gone out by now, I know that for definite. For definite, just an open fire. It would have died out by now, for sure. It's not doing half bad out there. 14:01. Fire's doing good. Still raining, but the fire have definitely outpaced the rain. So that's how you keep a real fire going. In the real rain. Okay, it was only 40 minutes, right, but pretty good rain for 40 minutes. That's how it's done. And that's with a less than optimal Siberian log fire. It's been there for, I don't know, 6-8 months. That's a long time. Alright there, guys, so that's how we keep a real fire going in the real rain. I'm taking it a little bit easy on feeding the fire at the moment, but I'm gonna use it for something else. But please check the links in the description. Please consider supporting the channel and the upcoming channel project. And until next time, guys, get out and train, get it done, do something awesome. And what is more to say than just see you in the next video, guys. Thank you very much for your time.